From News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 Now update.
Good morning and welcome back to News 8 Now. I'm Tracy Sable. The murder trial of Chad Gurney is over, and now it's up to a judge to decide whether Gurney will spend between 25 years to life in prison or be committed to the state psychiatric hospital for killing 18-year-old Zoe Sarnacki in 2009. And Thursday's closing arguments, the defense and prosecution clashed over Gurney's state of mind. The defense claiming Gurney was delusional and not criminally responsible by reason of insanity. While the prosecution admits Gurney did have problems, it argues that he knew what he was doing, fully doing, and was not suffering from a major mental illness. Outside the courtroom, Gurney's mother and sister pleaded for leniency.
I said, I love my son, the only comment I have.
And we are very sorry about this tragic event, but
we love.
Don't destroy two families just because one got taken away, because he's gone to us too, but we love him and we are very sorry for the Sarnacki family.
Justice Roland Cole has not set a date to announce his verdict, but he says it will be at least 4 to 5 days. Well, it was day 8 of testimony in the trial of a man accused of holding a group of 5th graders hostage. It happened at Stockton Springs Elementary School more than 2 years ago. Students who were taken hostage began taking the stand Thursday morning. Several told their own point of view about what happened when they say Randall Hofflin terrorized them back on Halloween of 2008. And were told the trial could last at least 2 more weeks. The Maine Senate has confirmed the first of Governor LePage's cabinet nominees, Sawin Millett, who becomes the state's finance commissioner. The Senate confirmed Millett unanimously Thursday, only hours before 3 other cabinet nominees faced legislative confirmation hearings. The Agriculture, Conservation and Forestry Committee endorsed the nomination of William Beardsley of Ellsworth for commissioner of the Conservation Department. The Labor, Commerce, Research and Economic Development Committee approved the appointment of Philip Congdon of Round Pond for Commissioner of Economic and Community Development. Norman Olson of Cherryfield, LePage's nominee for Marine Resources Commissioner, appeared before the committee that oversees offshore fishing activities. Governor LePage says he is looking for one of his new cabinet hires to focus on welfare reform when it comes to Maine's Department of Health and Human Services. Governor LePage spoke to News 8 about the issues that he would like Mary Mayhew to focus on.
The biggest thing I'm asking Mary to do at this point is to tackle the whole health care issue, both the federal programs, DERIGO, MaineCare, which we're in strong deficits. I mean, we haven't been paying the hospitals. We need to look at our mandates. We need to look at eligibility. And we need to look at Medicaid, Medicare, where reimbursement rates are far below costs. So
LePage also says Maine has joined a lawsuit with several other states opposing the mandated coverage portion of the president's health care plan. Some Democrats say repealing the law would create hardships for many Mainers and break promises to put people ahead of politics. Thanks for joining us here on News 8 Now. I'm Tracy Sable. Stay with us for the latest weather and sports highlights. We'll be right back.